What is good, YouTube?
YouTube.
Welcome to Champ Chatter. Bringing you back with the whole crew this time. So I'm here joined with, once again, Aaron.
Huzzah.
Liz.
Hi.
Piper.
Hi.
And returning guest, Nevaeh Pierre.
Hello.
Woo, very wrong one. So today you were going to present us with some event that was coming up?
Yes. So a couple weeks ago, me and Bybee and a couple other art people got together and we were like, well, we really want to go on this trip at the end of the year. How are we going to afford it? Well, me and Bybee were like, well,
who's
we could
Bybee?
Like,
sorry, I mean, interrupt.
Yeah, me and Mr. Bybee, the art teacher.
Okay.
We were like, well, what's something that could get people together for this next month? We are trying to consider things like the holidays that are coming up. So, you know, Valentine's Day, and then there's, like, diversity, inclusion, and equity that we want to bring into things. But we came to the conclusion of couples and canvases. So when people think of couples, they think of, you know, people who are dating. But
me and Piper are going as a Piper.
Yeah, I was thinking, like, we could be just, like, a couple of friends. Well, anyway, we decided to plan it just a couple days before Valentine's Day on February 9th. It's a Thursday. I know it's not like the weekend how everyone likes, but it just works out. 6 to 8 in the art room for all SCC students and staff, whoever wants to join. It's open, but there is a jot form online. They should be announcing it this week, and it should be in the hallways on those boards. I think that it'll be kind of full. So far, I have, like, half the people that I've been intending to get. So about, like, I'd say, like, 6 couples so far.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Is there a maximum capacity that you're reaching
so
for?
So 15 couples is as many as I can do because I have to, like, there's a lot I've been doing. I just have to prep the room. We have to clean everything. And
right. There's
only so many people who can teach in there. So it'll be me and Bybee, and hopefully we can get, like, you guys know Dylan and Anna Schroeder and all those great people. But what else is there about it? Oh, yeah, we'll have, like, some little setup where you guys can eat some food, some brownies, maybe some fruit, some drinks. I was debating on bringing milk, but the thought of it just doesn't sound very good.
If it's whole milk, then you got to do it.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay.
Whole milk is good. Y'all sleep.
Do you guys have any questions about it?
Does it cost anything?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So, I forgot. It is a fundraiser. So, it's $7.50 a person, but I'm intending on having a couple. So, $15 per couple, which really it's a little expensive, but it's because we have to be able to afford our trip that we're planning. And let me tell you about that. So,
good idea.
So, there's going to be like 9 of us going with, and I'll meet Bybee's wife. We'll go to Kansas City to see some museums and some, maybe some like art in the parks and stuff.
Right.
But I'm not, we're still planning it, so.
Okay.
It'll only be like 2 days in April. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, I'm really excited about it. It's kind of scary planning it though. So.
It sounds like it'd be a cool experience overall though.
Yeah.
Kansas City is really cool. I have an uncle who lives over there and it's one of my favorite places. I love visiting him, mainly because I love to go to Kansas City.
Well, there was a lot of confusion when we were planning it, because, like, there's Kansas City, Missouri, and then it's, like, connected with Kansas. Yeah, and everyone was like, there's nothing in Kansas. Why would we go there? And I'm like, I thought there was, I don't know, I thought it was, like,
Missouri.
The same thing.
It's, like, all in
Missouri. No. The Kansas side is the barren side. Missouri is where it's at for
Kansas. Where it's popping.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Word.
Dylan! Well.
Came in right on time, somewhat.
I rung it in. Well, I talked
Dylan,
about it.
Another member of the art club just walked
that you'd
in,
like
everybody.
To share
yo.
Interesting?
Welcome, Dylan.
Woo!
We do need like a little romantic music playlist, so if you guys have any.
Dylan just offered that we come in and play romantic music as background
for really good
the paintings. That would really set the mood.
Yeah, I was thinking, well, if there's going to be, like, international students coming in, maybe I could do something cool in their languages, but I'm more of, like, a little 90s R&B love. That's about it, though. So.
Yeah, good era.
Yeah.
I mean, it's hard to go wrong.
Absolutely. I know, with some, like, Aaliyah or something, or Usher. Mm. Just fangirling.
Boys to Men.
Boys to Men.
Yeah.
Yeah.
New
My dad put me on.
Luther. Luther Vandross.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know.
That's a little bit older than the 90s, but that's a good song, too.
I don't know. I just like that song. It sounds nice. Makes me cry every time.
So oh. Me too. Is anyone else coming? I definitely recommend maybe you guys can come together.
Yeah. I don't know. What day is it again?
February 9th.
From 6 to 8.
6 to 8, yes.
Is that a Friday?
It's a Thursday.
Oh, it's a Thursday. Maybe. Maybe then.
Perhaps.
Okay, I'll take that.
I was going to say that Friday is kind of booked for me that night.
Well, I guess it's perfect that I chose a... Yes.
February 9th.
Oh, I am? Oh, that's right. Yeah, I am booked. I cannot come to that.
Daniel Pappas has declared that Aaron is booked.
I forgot about that. I even put it down in my calendar, too.
Oh, I do that all the time.
Do we have that list?
Dylan's yet? Never booked.
Okay, cool. All
right.
Well, I think that's about it.
Yeah, do you have any other closing remarks?
Well, come join Art Club. I mean, we always like some help with fundraising and getting people, you know, connected in the school.
When are your meetings?
Yeah, and traveling. They are Thursday at 9 a.m. in the art room.
Every Thursday?
Yeah, every Thursday. Okay. So far.
And where's the art room again?
The art room is room 142. It's all the way at the hall, down the hall in the 100 near building. The
oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, past the library. So, yeah.
All right.
Anybody's welcome.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you very
Thanks
much.
For joining us.
I feel so terrible for that. Because the email you sent, it said the time, but it didn't say where.
Oh.
I was like.
Yeah.
Oops. I was like, I've seen you guys record. And,
that's on me. I'd rather tell Dylan where we were.
All right.
All right. Goodbye. Yeah.
So now we'll talk about our pop up next
music.
Week on Monday. We're gonna have we're gonna be playing a nice little song in Italian for diversity and inclusion stuff. So that's gonna be fun. Do we know where that's gonna be in a general area yet? Okay, it's going to be at 2 p.m. on Monday, so
somewhere.
Be sure to watch the Music Club account if you want to figure out where it is.
And that is SCC Iowa Music.
On Instagram.
Yeah, follow us on Instagram.
Follow us or else.
Yeah. And we have more planned in the works as well, so be on the lookout.
Yes, indeed.
Other than that... other school news we have going on. It is International Science Black History Month, so I'm sure that our school is planning things around that.
Any student board connections want to come out of the woodwork?
Hold on, I got some.
All right, cool.
It's in my backpack.
Just have a little
I do know that they are showing from Tuesday the 7th to Tuesday the 14th, they will be showing a Hulu series known as the 1619 Project.
I heard about that.
I've seen a couple commercials about it.
It does. They'll be showing that in the Little Theater from 10 one showing from 10 to 11 a.m. and 3 to 4 p.m. They'll be showing an episode a day. So if you want to tune into
I think that's
to the Little Theater and
it
watch.
Is.
Are we ready for the February student activities?
Yes, Piper.
Hit it.
So DEI and Student Activities is going to present a 1619 Project. It's a Hulu series. It's a six-part series, and it's going to be showing February 7th through the 14th at 10 to 11 p.m. and 3 to 4, and then it's going to be in the Little Theater. February 6th, 11 to 1, in the private dining room will be Black Hair Culture event, so they're going to do, like, hair braiding, haircuts. It's all free. And then February 6th again is another food culture event. It's going to feature a bunch of Chinese food, 11 to 1, in the cafeteria. I'm out of breath. Okay. February 14th is Valentine's Day. That's a Tuesday, and we're going to be handing out Valentine's cookies. And then the music pop-up concerts, we already talked about that. And then February 22nd is a food feature for Japanese pancakes, 11 to 1 in the private dining room.
Ooh.
And then we're going to do a Black History banquet, but we're still figuring out times and dates and rooms and whenever that's going to be.
I'm going to make my way down.
Nice.
Japanese pancakes.
Thing. Yeah, those are good at the Thanksgiving dinner. Mm-hmm. And that was the news.
Wow.
All right. Now, let me see what music picks y'all presented to me this week.
All right.
And I'll show you mine in exchange. I believe the theme was songs that get your day off to a right start. Yes. All right. Roll it.
So the first one's mine.
Maybe.
If it plays.
Yeah.
And it's a Vienna cover.
It sounds so good.
And no one is surprised, but it's really good, and I really enjoy it. It's very, like, kind of twangy. Again, no one is surprised.
Twangy.
I found the one kind of country version of Vienna, and yeah.
I bet it sounds good.
It is good. I found it off of TikTok.
Huh.
Yeah.
That's where I find some of my songs, too.
Oh. Nope, that's not mine. There it is.
Excellent.
Very good, very good.
Yeah, I like that.
TikTok.
I never listened to Billy Joel prior to that concert, so now, like, every time I hear a song, it's like, it brings me back to that, and it's just good music. Like, I don't know why I never heard of it prior to the concert. All right, this next track is mine. This is Fantasy by Eternity Forever. You know about this, Aaron?
I do not know.
Really? Because it's Kurt Travis once again.
Oh, really?
Yes, I played his other band's music about a couple months ago. This is a band he added just for this one EP. So check it out.
Come on.
I wish I could play the whole thing because that clip does not do it justice.
Who's playing guitar on this one?
I don't know, but it's the same band as Gold Necklace. I'm sure you know them.
Oh, okay, yes.
They just replaced the bassist for Gold Necklace because of beef or something.
Mm-hmm,
my sister showed me that group, and I'm very thankful.
Yeah, that song is groovy.
Yes,
I really love the snappy, like, math rock sound that Kurt Travis has, like, where it's like...
Yes, I love it. It's very calculated, but, like, it also feels organic, too.
Well, yeah, like, it's still really good. It's just, like, the perfect blend between, like, the virtuoso guitarist and a functional guitarist.
Yeah, that's well said. There's nothing I want to say about it, but I forgot. This is
this next one is mine, yeah. So this is Heaven by Angels and Airwaves. Tom DeLonge, formerly of Blink-182, and now once again, actually, sort of broke off from Blink to write his, more serious music with this group, essentially. This is on his second album.
Word.
Yeah, it's good stuff.
Getting started too, but
yeah it's all good.
Why do you like to wake up to that song?
Something about it just soars. It like
revs up.
It feels like you feel it. It's what I call it's like their second like really really good song. Like they have their first really good song was The Adventure, which is like the big thing that Angels and Airwaves did, but I think that song is better. Because it sounds so much bigger. There's more. It, like, culminates into, like, a bigger sound.
Yeah, it does sound pretty grandiose.
The other thing is it's basically, like, pop-punk supergroup. The drummer is the drummer from 30 Seconds to Mars before he went.
What?
Yeah, before he went to touring with Laura Jane Grace and a couple of other bands as well. It's a bunch of really good pop-punk names in there.
Nice.
Yeah.
Something of a supergroup.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Piper.
It's my
what you
song.
Got for us?
It's All I Woo! Wanted by Paramore.
This is a good song.
So good.
Yes. I love this song.
I like the part, kind of towards the end, like where it goes completely silent and just her screaming it out. That's my favorite part. So like when I go to work in the morning, at like 6 in the morning, I'm just like,
think of me when you're out there. I'll beg you nice for my knees. when the world treats you way too fairly. Well, it's a shame I'm a dream.
Yeah.
I love that song. It's a good song.
It kind of speaks for itself in a way.
Not going to lie, texting my band group chat right now to see if we can do this song.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. That'd be quite the performance to see.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. It'll be good. We'll figure something out.
You got to do it now.
Yeah, you got to dig deep for that one, Aaron.
It's easy. It's not going to be hard.
All right, and that was our music picks for the week. Speaking of the week, how's y'all's week been? I agree with you there.
You know, it hasn't been bad. It's just been long.
Yeah, it's been really inconvenient.
Yeah,
just a lot of little things.
Yeah,
spill it up.
Yeah.
Yesterday was really good, but like the rest of the week has been okay.
Why?
My classes were done at 9:20, so I just went home and I like cleaned my entire room, vacuumed it, did all my laundry, washed my sheets, just did so much like cleaning, and I just feel good.
Yeah, there you go.
Hell yeah.
I made creme brulee last night. That was pretty cool.
For real?
Yeah.
How do you make that?
How to video.
First, you can do one of two things. You have to choose how you're gonna have your vanilla. Do you want the beans or do you want the extract? The bean is like $16 at Hy-Vee.
We don't want
just
beans.
One bean.
What?
Now,
which one tastes better?
The bean. The bean absolutely tastes better, but you can get more vanilla flavor by adding in the extract.
Trade-offs.
I do like half and half. I like half the amount of bean in there to put more vanilla extract in there. Get a little bit of that. Then you heat that in your cream. While the cream is heating, you mix up your eggs and sugar. Then essentially what you have to do is you have to pour in enough cream to heat the eggs and temper them, but not make scrambled eggs.
Yeah.
Then you bake it in an oven for about 30 minutes and let it sit until it's like hardened up a little bit, and then you throw your sugar on top and torch it.
Word.
Blowtorch?
Yes.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. It's hard, but it pays off.
An extreme dessert.
I also put in some lemon zest and a little bit of lemon juice, so it gets a little bit more flavor than just vanilla pudding.
It's kind of zesty.
Yeah. Just a little bit. It's a little bit zesty, not too much, just a little. A little goes a long way.
For sure.
Well, how was your week, Jordan?
My week, busy.
Yeah? What have
when
you been
when I first
up
got
to?
Here, it's a school and like other obligations I have in the gym as well. And I'm looking back, like last year when I first moved here, I was coasting it, honestly. I was doing 12 hours. I didn't know nobody. So I was like, you know, I'm just going to get my stuff done and go home and, you know, just do nothing.
Oops, you got attached.
Yeah, y'all got me in Iowa, man. Okay. And a year later, 15 hours running three clubs. I don't want to say running because it's a team effort. but Piper runs. But yeah, it's pushing me to my limits, but I don't know, I'll grow from it, from this discomfort.
That's the important thing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's what I was thinking about last night too, because the cold had me thinking that we kind of have it good now, if you think about it. For example, like, if you look back to, like, the early 1900s, they didn't have heat, they didn't have air conditioning, they didn't have, like, good foundational structures like we do now. So when it was cold, they were really SOL.
For sure.
It really had me thinking, like, do we, with this comfort and the societal, because it goes without saying now, like, depression has, like, been higher than ever. I didn't mean to make it, like, that all serious.
Seasonal depression.
Seasonal depression. But our generation as well, like, generational depression.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Does comfort equate to quality of life? What do y'all think?
Equate is a strong word. I wouldn't say equate. I'd say strongly correlates, though.
Okay.
I think if you are the more comfortable you are, the more likely it is that you are a little bit happier, a little less depressed. I mean, obviously there are different goalposts for different people, but I think for the most part, the closer you are to, like, high levels of comfort, the more likely it is that you are not going to have quite as much of that.
Yeah.
Why do you think that is?
Because you're set. You don't have to worry about much.
Yeah, I think it's a worry thing. Mm. Like, a lot of people are like, money can't buy happiness. But the thing is the more money you have, a lot of your problems turn into, like, not problems anymore.
Absolutely.
Like, you can afford food.
Security.
You can afford food. You can afford, like, to pay rent or pay your taxes, pay your bills, whatever. That takes off a lot of stress when you can do a lot of that.
Yeah, that is true.
Yeah, and then it's hard because every, like, job around, like, you either have to have a degree, which we don't have yet. I mean, some of us do.
Or 10 years experience. But not a high enough
degree. Yeah. Or you got to know somebody.
For, like, a $10 an hour job. So then people are working three jobs just to pay rent when older generations have a stable full-time job that's paying them yearly just set.
Yeah.
Which it would take us a while. I mean, not a while, but it'll take us a bit
it'll
to get
time.
To
Absolutely.
That point.
Do we need to consult Psych Club on this?
We probably should. Bless you.
Bless you.
I do not consider myself a contrarian, but on the contrary, I kind of believe the opposite. Just because, well, I don't want to get the whole spiel of my life leading up to this point, but the whole reason I moved up here was because I was too comfortable and I was unhappy with my life. I didn't really have a purpose. I was just going day by day, working, getting enough just to, you know, I was living with my parents at the time. I was living in an apartment, but after the fact, I spent the last half of 2021 with my parents, so I didn't really have to worry about rent too much. But I was just working and just, like, living for pleasure, I guess you could say.
I wouldn't even really call that on the contrary. I would say you became uncomfortable with being comfortable.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think at some level, you know, that does happen from time to time. You get disillusioned with your day-to-day. You get sort of that routine that you fall into, and you start feeling like, man, it's just the same thing every day, and it's not what
Quarter
I want
life
it to
crisis.
Be.
Monotonous.
But
I was going to finish by saying, when I moved up here, it was really like a lot of change because I didn't know anybody but my aunt. And during that time, I was really uncomfortable. But from it, I learned a lot about myself. I learned about the world and just where I fit. And through that, it gave me a lot of confidence. It gave me a lot of, like, purpose. And I learned a lot about myself. So I would say, I don't want to say that comfort's not crucial, because if I was completely on my own, shoot, I don't know how I would have been. I don't want to take for granted what I have, because I'm very grateful for everything I have. But I think that to some extent, we all got to have a level of discomfort in our lives it's almost like a balance. I read in a book.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
There's order and chaos, yin and yang. And you need both to have a fulfilling life. As Piper pulls out her yin-yang tattoo.
And there is order in the chaos and chaos in the order.
That's absolutely.
That's what the little dot in the center of each represents.
Yeah, you got to have organized chaos.
Yes.
Get through it.
Mm-hmm.
So ultimately, the answer to my first question, both.
Yeah, you know. Like in philosophical questions about life that are of that level, there's no right answer. It's more like, what's best for the individual.
Absolutely. Like, Aaron, would you say, I don't mean to make it all about me, but Aaron, would you say, like, when you're first learning to play an instrument, it feels very uncomfortable, but then once you learn it, you're just like, hell yeah.
Absolutely. Especially with the instruments that I've learned how to play, there is a very direct correlation between the amount of pain that goes through the first half of the learning curve and then when that goes away, you start feeling a lot less of that. Like guitar, for instance, when you're first starting out and you're first playing, you have to develop calluses because your fingers aren't like used to pressing down on the metal mm-hmm. of the string. But after a few years, you get used to that sort of thing and, you know, it just makes everything easier. So when that translated really well to playing bass, so now I'm developing calluses on my other fingers, too. So it's all come full circle, really. But once you've made it past a lot of those hurdles, it becomes a lot easier.
Yeah. Well, Liz Piper, do you have anything to add? Because y'all have been kind of quiet about this conversation.
I agree with everything.
Well, I don't mean to like put you on the spot, but I'm curious. I'm curious about y'all's perspective.
I agree with everything. It's just too early to think that deep.
But I agree with everything. But yeah, I have my yin and yang tattoo. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know all too well.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
we know all.
All yeah. Knowing.
All right, guys. Well, it's been great again.
Woo! Yeah, that's it's been good.
The crew is back together again,
welcome
guys.
Back.
Yes.
Yeah, 2 weeks from now, we'll be back.
Yep.
Huzzah.
So we'll see you on 2 weeks, probably with the new guests.
Catch
new
you on
events
the flip
coming
side.
Up, and maybe we'll see you club. Then.